caught in the crossfire. A 15-month-old's senseless murder brings a local community together in a passionate plea for change. But something happened tonight as hundreds of people gathered to remember little Marcus White. A call loud and clear to end the no-snitch lifestyle before any more children die. It had everything, balloons, teddy bears, candles. But this vigil for this little boy grew into much more.
There's a thing a sister said this morning. She said, I stick by the code. I don't talk to the police. Well, I have some information about that. The criminals don't stick to the code today.
Thank you.
So why should we be held accountable to a bondage of the snitching creed?
Did you hear that? He said bondage to the snitching creed. A culture of silence after violence. But tonight,
how many of our kids we gonna let go?
That culture started to change. In a bitter chill, East Hills stood up.
I buried my son a year ago.
And they rose from a toddler's ashes.
I'm sick and tired of these kids dying in these streets.
Men stepped forward, women held their children, and they signed this goodbye to little Marcus White, each signature a pledge to, from now on, do what's right.
That means it's up to us to change the atmosphere in East Hills.
Yes.
In Homewood, in Garfield,
on
the Hill District.
Yes.
It's up to us.
Powerful. Police have made no arrests in that backyard picnic gunfire that also injured two of little Marcus White's aunts. Neighbors hope tonight's vigil changes that.